Hello students, good afternoon to all of you. Today we are going to discuss a chapter and the name of the chapter is Three at Table. So here Three at Table means there are three persons who are sitting at a table, and I'm sure you know that whenever we sit with our friends or anyone in a table, there goes a lot of discussions, right? So here we'll study that there were three friends who were sitting in a table and they were discussing about something. Now, what is that something? For that, we have to move forward. Okay, so before we start, it is very important to know who is the writer of the chapter that we are studying. So, the author is W.W. Jacobs. He has written this story. The scene of the story starts in a coffee room. Coffee room is a place where you sit and you have your coffee or any tea or any beverage. A few men start a conversation on ghosts. So I am sure that whenever you sit with your friends or aap jab ghost ki baatein start kar dete ho, to that becomes itself an interesting topic because everybody comes up with your stories. So here when they were sitting, three people were sitting at a table in the coffee room, they started a conversation about ghosts. Now let's see what was the conversation between them. Okay, now you can see this image of a ghost. I'm sure ki aap mein se, if there are 100% people, 60% of people are afraid of ghost, and so am I. So whenever we start talking of ghosts, some who are not afraid of ghost, unko wo conversation achhi lagti hai. But who are afraid of ghost, they don't want to listen. But because this is a chapter and we have to study it, so let's see. The talk in the this we've already studied. I would not advise you to believe all those, said a clean-shaven man who had been listening without speaking much. Up, ye chapter is about a person. His name is not been mentioned. As you can see, isme likha hai clean-shaven man. ठीक है, तो इसमें बताया नहीं गया है कि वो पर्सन का नेम क्या है. सो थ्रू आउट द स्टोरी उसका नेम बस क्लीन शेवन मैन ही दिया है कि क्लीन शेवन मैन ने बोला. एंड क्लीन शेवन मैन इज अ पर्सन हु डजंट हैव एनी बियर्ड और मुस्टैच इन हिज फेस. यू सी व्हेन अ सेलर गेट्स अशोर, अशोर मीन्स अपने सेलिंग जर्नी, इफ यू कैन सी इन द पिक्चर वॉयेज, वहाँ से जब रिटर्न होता है, इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू हैव समथिंग गुड टू टेल, एंड हिज फ्रेंड्स वुड बी रैदर डिसअपॉइंटेड इफ ही हैड नॉट. अगर आप लोग एक ट्रिप में जाएंगे एंड व्हेन यू विल कम बैक फ्रॉम देयर, एवरीबडी एक्सपेक्ट्स फ्रॉम यू दैट यू आर गोइंग टू शेयर योर स्टोरी, योर एक्सपीरियंस कि आप कहाँ घूमने गए थे. तो इसमें यही बोला गया है दैट वेन अ पर्सन कम्स फ्रॉम हिज जर्नी, तो एवरीबडी एक्सपेक्ट्स फ्रॉम हिम कि वो कुछ ना कुछ अपनी कोई स्टोरी बताएगा. एंड इफ ही डजंट टेल, पीपल गेट डिसअपॉइंटेड. डिसअपॉइंटेड मतलब वो निराश हो जाते हैं. नाउ ही स्टार्ट्स हिज स्टोरी. द पर्सन इज अ क्लीन शेवन मैन. I was a young man at the time, he began. So now he was telling ki ye apne wo pehle ki story bata raha tha ki when he was young what happened to him. My family was away, so I invited myself to stay with an uncle. So when his family was away, he was all alone, wo apne ek uncle ke paas rehne gaya tha. So I decided, so again, whenever this I word is being used, I is used for the clean shaven man. Like I told, his name is not been mentioned. So he decided to stay at a Royal George, a very decent inn. Inn means place. If you can see in the picture, this is the Royal George. Wo wahan stay karne gaya tha with his uncle. Because he was young, he could not stay alone. So that is the reason why when his parents were away, he went to his uncle. The next morning after a late breakfast, I set off for a walk. Usually whenever we are filled up, whenever we eat properly, we want to go for a walk, right? So in the morning itself, when he had his breakfast, uska man hua, because he ate heavy breakfast, uska man hua that to go on a walk. I lunched luxurious. Luxuriously means when you eat a good lunch, that is known as I lunched luxuriously, and decided to go a little further before turning back. So after having a good lunch, after having a heavy lunch, he decided to go for a walk, for a long walk in fact. When I found I had come far away, I lost my way. So what happened when you go to a new place? So because that place was a new, because he went to his uncle's place, usually what happens ki hum rasta bhul jate hain. So when he went for a walk, he lost his way because that was a different place, he didn't know the way. Now let's see what happened. If you can see in the picture, this is the picture of a fog. And what is fog? Kohra. And usually you find it in winter season. So from this picture and from this fog, we come to know that the season there was winter season. I was so caught up in a fog and want to read about Mr. Bean shouting for help. So he was caught in fog, and in fog you cannot see any person who is standing in front of you, or you by far up dur dur tak kuch nahi dekh sakte hain. So he was shouting for help because he was stuck there. He didn't knew the place ki wo wapas kaise aayega. So he started shouting for help. A man came for my help. So when he was shouting, there was a kind man who heard his voice and he came to help him. And then he also gave him instructions that how to reach the closest village. Closest means jo bhi pass wala village where he could go and stay for a time being. He gave him that address. Now if you can see from the picture itself that the man is knocking the door, that means he would have found a place. Soon I came to a small gate. There was no light and no sound from within. So when he came to a place, to a nearby village after walking for a long mile, I knocked lightly upon the door. Again, I is the clean-shaven man. He was telling the story. He was narrating the story to his friends. So he said that when he came to a small gate, there was no light and sound from within. That means he felt that nobody is there inside the home. Because जब हम घर में रहते हैं, we always switch on the light and there are some sounds from inside. But the place where he went, वहाँ कोई भी आवाज़ नहीं थी and there was no lights. I waited for a couple of minutes and then knocked again. So he knocked for some time and then he waited. But when there was no voice from inside, he again knocked the door. Now from the picture, what can you imagine? You can see a lady who's holding a candle in her hand, and this in the second picture you can see that there is a emoji who is frustrated. The door opened suddenly and an old man holding a candle stood before me. So when he again knocked the door, to jaise door open hua, an old lady came out and she was holding a candle in her hand. That means अभी हमने जैसे देखा था, पढ़ा था कि the man when he was knocking the door, there was no light inside. So the lady came with a candle in her hand because there was no light. What do you want? She demanded gruffly. Gruffly means in a rough voice, जब आप गुस्से में बोलते हो. So she was frustrated for the man who came at her door, and that is the reason why in frustration she asked him, what do you want? That means तुम्हें क्या चाहिए? I have lost my way, I said. I want to get to Asheville. Asheville is the place where he came from. And he said that, oh lady, that I have lost my way. That means main apna rasta se bhatak gaya hoon. And he didn't knew the address. So that is the reason why he came there for help. Don't know it, said the old woman. So that old woman was very rude, because earlier also in the first question when she asked, तब भी शी आस्क्ड वेरी रूडली एंड इवन नाउ शी वाज सेइंग कि आई डोंट नो, मुझे नहीं पता द वे टू एशविल. शी वाज अबाउट टू क्लोज द डोर व्हेन अ मैन केम बिहाइंड हर. सो व्हेन शी वाज अबाउट टू शट द डोर, देयर वाज अ मैन, इफ यू कैन सी इन द पिक्चर, ही केम बिहाइंड हर एंड ही केम देयर फॉर हेल्प बिकॉज द ओल्ड लेडी वाज वेरी रूड एंड शी डिडंट वांटेड टू आंसर टू अ स्ट्रेंज पर्सन. सो हर हस्बैंड केम बैक behind her to answer the question to this man. So now whatever is been left, we are going to study tomorrow. By till now, I want you all to go through the video and go through the chapter. Thank you, students.